Hello everyone, Qsan is here again. Today I share you some tips and tricks to make your illustration softer and brighter in a few steps using combinations of overlay, soft light and Gaussian blur. Let's start! Open your work in Clip Studio Paint. As you can see, my illustration is almost completed, but I want to give it a softer feeling, emphasizing the character's emotions and the background atmosphere. I can use different methods. The first technique is using one color. Create a new layer. Then, go to Tool, Fill, refer only to Editing Layer, fill the layer with your favorite pastel color. I use the pink-red color. Once colored, go to the layer property, Soft Light. Keeping the opacity to 100%, I can see how the color overlaps the image perfectly, giving the illustration an aesthetic vibe, a brightness contrast, and that tone of red as filter. You can put a saturated color to make the filter color stronger. Keeping the same work, create a new layer. Go to Tool, Gradient. As you can see, Clip Studio Paint gives us some standard gradients. The first and the second one are customizable with the main and secondary color in the toolbar. Going to Tool Property, Settings, Advanced Settings. I can assess some hidden gradients and full sets with a lot of combinations. Take a moment to see the setting menu. I can edit an existing gradient, changing the color and putting the main drawing color and the sub-drawing color. I can choose a different color going to specified color. Clicking on the icon, I can assess the color settings and pick the one I want. In the PC Mac version, with the eyedropper, I can also select a specific color from a photo or a custom palette. With other options, I have the position of the color, the opacity of the color. If I add a third point, I can activate the mixing rate curve and decide the mixing of the color with others near to it. Higher curves will have a less color blur. Lower curves will have a wide color blur. Come back to the gradient set. In the right bottom, I have some icons. In the first one, I can replace saved gradient with a custom combination. Load to gradient bar will load the selected gradient. With duplicate selected gradient, I can duplicate a gradient in the set, so I can edit it without touching the first one. Create a new gradient, delete gradient. If I click the second icon here, I can find the same options with the possibility to create a new set, a new folder, where to save our custom gradients. I can also upload gradients to the community by going to Clip Studio Assets. Having custom gradients is always helpful. It's like always having filters available which can define and enrich our style and art. I can add my own gradients in the main tool too. Go to the subtool and duplicate a gradient clicking the second icon. Then, drag and drop the copied one in the subtool bar to have a new tool session. Duplicate the tool again. Then, go to Tool Property, Advanced Settings, Gradient Set, and create Add Your Gradient. It will be memorized in the subtool. After choosing your color combination, go to Layer Property, Soft Light. As you can see, overlapping colors in the drawing are mixed, creating a good combination. You can use the overlay instead of the soft light to make the light dark color stronger. If you need, change the opacity to better mix the gradient. The last technique I'm showing is the most useful in giving the final and perfect aesthetic vibe. Go to Layer, right-click, Duplicate Layer. Then, go to Menu, Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. This option makes your work blurrier, changing the strength value. Usually this filter is used to blur some parts in the foreground or in the background of your work, simulating a camera focusing on your character. In this case, I'll use it on the entire work to create a texture. Choose the strength value as you prefer. I change the value to 100. Click OK. Then, go to Layer, Soft Light. As you can see, the blurred image is overlapped perfectly, making the light parts brighter and shadow parts darker. The soft atmosphere makes the work romantic and emotional. If you need, change the opacity as you prefer, adding the texture to the work. Done! I hope these teeny tips can help you to give vibes in your drawings. They are easy steps, but the final result is so satisfying and completed. As always, don't forget to share your work with us. We can't wait to see your art. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!